Mary, what's going on?
Enjoying the day. Yeah, how are you?
I'm doing well. It's bright and sunny. It seems like it's bright and sunny on your end too.
It's foggy, it's overcast, but hey, I'll take it.
Nice. Well, congratulations on your bot client again. I know that you landed your bot client before the course even started. What the heck? How did you even do that?
I landed two clients before the course started. I landed two clients
Whoa.
before I even talked to Andrew, and that's the reason. So he did his webinar. He absolutely blew my mind when I saw what he was doing. It was a way beyond an aha moment. It was the aha moment I had when I started my first business. When I first got the entrepreneurial bug, it was like, oh my gosh, I have to do this. But before I was going to invest anything in doing any course, I had to prove to myself that I could do this, that I could sell what I thought I was going to be able to sell.
Yeah.
And so I set up the call. I think the webinar was on a Thursday. I think my call with Andrew was on a Tuesday. And I gave myself that time to see if I could sell this, talk to someone from what I understood and sell it to them. And so I just went to Facebook. And I looked at my little list on the side there of all the people that were live that I could chat with, that I were in my network. And I just started saying hi to people. And there were people that were not my clients. They were not, they had been on my podcast, but I wasn't really engaged with them very much at all, just periodically on Facebook. And so I just messaged them saying, hey, what's going on? What are you working on? How you doing? Haven't talked to you for a while. Just started a conversation. And then asked them what they were doing. And they said, well, I'm working on this funnel. I'm working on this sales process. I'm kind of frustrated. And so we just started talking about it. What are you frustrated about? And just basically did like a mini discovery call in chat. And through that process, I said, you know what? I am developing this brand new tool that I think would be exactly the answer to what you're looking for. Can we chat a little bit further on Skype so I can tell you about it? Here's a link. And I had just made, right after I got off that webinar, went into Chat Fuel and just did a quick little sequence to see how it worked.
Whoa.
And I said, check it out. Let me know what you think. And both of them were, I had talked to three people, so pretty high sales rate. I sold, two out of three.
Two out of three.
And they all were blown away and of course confused and not quite sure and so where does email fit and how does this work? And so I got on a Skype call and for some reason it totally clicked for me when Andrew did. I just saw exactly what I could do with this in funnels in relation to email marketing. And basically, so I explained it to them and I said, so, and I did kind of a mini coaching call with one of them because she had a funnel where her opt-in, her lead magnet didn't really lead to exactly her, what she was trying to sell. Those two things were incongruent. So I was like, okay, wait a minute. You got to make sure that's fixed first. And so then through that, I said, how would you like to try this? Because both of them had done launches of courses last year at the same time using the email funnel and were very successful. This year they deployed the same process and crickets. And this
Wow.
was to new audience and to their existing. So they still had a good list of people that were coming in, but nobody was buying and nobody was opening their emails. So
Wow.
they were prime.
What do you think happened from the last launch to this launch?
The products themselves were not different, but the only thing that changed was their email open rates. Their email open rates went through the just, less than 20% before. They were 40, 50, 60% last year.
Whoa.
And now this year, nobody was opening their emails, nobody was engaging, and nobody was buying.
That's
They
pretty drastic, huh?
had like two sales or something. So
Wow.
they were primed. They were just like, give me anything. My business, I can't keep doing it this way.
Yeah. Wow, that's amazing. And then you just basically did what most, real entrepreneurs would do is like find out the real problem and see how you could possibly solve that problem.
That's it. And I have to tell you, one of the things during the webinar, I kept pushing Andrew in the chat. I asked him, how much would you sell this for? And he didn't answer me at first. He's like, oh, you could sell it for anything. And I'm like, no, really, how much would you sell it for? Because I knew I was going to do this. Yeah. So I had to have some kind of frame of reference. And he says, oh, you can probably sell it for $1,000. I'm like, okay, $1,000. I'll grab that. And that's exactly what I told him, $1,000. And they both went, okay.
Wow, really?
And then I also told them it would be at least $300 a month to maintain it.
And they said yes.
They said yes.
And so this was before the course, before you actually were really skilled at building it. What happened next? Did you say, give me a few weeks to learn this? And
yeah, I basically told them, well, both of them weren't ready immediately. So they were going to be ready sometime in March. Mm-hmm. And I was very honest. I said, this is brand new. This is totally new. The thing I showed you is just a demo. It doesn't work like the real one's going to work. It's not going to look exactly the same. But, you know, Tam, I am in marketing. So I do email marketing all the time. And really, I have another client that I just sold recently and trying to explain it to her. This is the exact same thing as email. The only difference is they're giving us permission to communicate with them somewhere else, mm-hmm. not in email. So in email, it's basically when they subscribe, they're just giving us permission to communicate with them through email. Yep. This is, they're giving us permission to communicate with them through Facebook Messenger. That's it. It's, other than that, it's the exact same thing. Mm-hmm. Except of course, I call it marketing speak. The marketing speak in email is very different from the marketing speak in chat. Yeah. That's the big difference. Awesome. I think it's to our advantage.
That's an amazing story. Thank you for sharing. Is there anything else that you wanted to, any last words before we end this?
Don't use the word bot. That's it. Until you get into it, until when you're first pitching this to people, don't talk about bots, because that is going to be a barrier, because most people really don't know what you're talking about, or they might have some other preconceived idea of what that is. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, just talk about what it's going to do, what you're going to do, and then bring in when they ask you, how does it work? Say, well, it's actually kind of like a chat bot. And then you go into that if they really want to know. But by then, the process is what they're buying, not a bot.
Beautifully said. All right. Mary, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you.